So yeah, welcome to Future Me. This is the very first session. Today's very much about an introduction, you getting to know us, us getting to know you, and us figuring out how everything is going to work, answering any initial questions, but also making sure that you all know what it is that you're going to expect over the next few weeks. So I'll leave it to Nicola to talk about what our outcomes are going to be.
Okay, so we're obviously going to have 6 weeks of this, but today's one is all about kind of understanding what employability skills are, identifying the range of employability skills that are essential in the world of work, and obviously how you're going to be able to apply those as well going forward. Hopefully, you'll be able to demonstrate understanding of what your own skills and qualities are as well, and we are going to get you to do some self-assessment quizzes, which will kind of help you kind of pinpoint where your interests may lie and obviously what you can go on to do in the future kind of with those interests, with those skills as well. We are also going to hopefully let you understand how the world of work is changing and obviously the technological advances that we are having sort of day to day, the impact those may well have on your futures and how that will look for you in the world of work in the future as well. So a fair few things to be doing, but they're all quite basic things, and it's just very much setting you up for the next kind of 6 weeks as well for our employer pathways and things.
Yeah, thank you. And Gerard, who are we going to be meeting this week, or over the next few weeks, sorry?
So we have got five really interesting, rather exciting employers who are going to be live online talking to us. First of all, we've got Hariba Myra. So Robin Spence is going to join us. She's a graduate engineer with Hariba Myra. They're a world-class vehicle engineering testing facility out in Hinckley. So they have companies in their premises like Jaguar Land Rover, Aston Martin, Bentley, but also they've got some really interesting companies doing a lot of research and development around artificial intelligence and automotive. So they do some really cool stuff over there. And they've been on things like Top Gear as well. So I think we're gonna enjoy that one. We're gonna be joined by Kate Lee from Samworth Brothers. So Samworth are a chilled food provider. So they make things like sandwiches, they make ginsters pasties, they make my own favorite, which is soaring malt loaf. But her role is about actually looking at how they, as a business, attract new talent, how they grow, and how they make sure that actually they're an organization that somebody like you wants to go and work for. Then we've got Kath Bunger, who's going to join us from AXA PPP Healthcare. So Kath is the CSR, that's Corporate and Social Responsibility Education Manager, and they give health and wellbeing advice services to over 9.9 million customers in the world. So that's quite a lot of people. But Kath's involved in a lot of the education programs and the outreach programs that AXA Healthcare do. We've got Crown Packaging. So Jackie is going to be joining us from Crown Packaging. She's the HR manager there, and they're a global packaging company right here in Leicestershire. You might not have heard of them, but I guarantee you've probably used their products because they make cans and tins for organisations like Coca-Cola. So they really are quite a leader in their sector of manufacturing and engineering. So just to give you a bit of a size of an idea of size, they've got 33,000 employees worldwide. And last year they recorded sales of £11.7 billion. So we're talking quite a lot of business there. And then finally, but absolutely not least, we've got Colab Creation. So Dan Lamoon, who is the creator, the founder, and the managing director of Colab Creation, he's going to be joining us. Dan's mission is about creating compelling video stories that will engage people. He's got a big passion for videography, storytelling, and e-learning. So all of those employees are going to join us. So make sure you've got your questions ready because they're going to be here to answer them. Thanks, Becca.
Fantastic. So I've just put in the chat, I can see a few raised hands. I'm not sure if that's from before or if people do have questions, but if anyone wants to type their questions now or say their questions, now would be a good time. We can answer them for you. Silence, cool. I'll move on. And like I said, you can ask questions at any time. I'll make sure that we pick them up. I'll also try and make sure I do the PowerPoint the right way. So as Jara's just said, this is all about you guys. So what we wanted to do was to make sure that even though we're all in lockdown, even though we can't have you on our uni campuses, even though we can't take you to different places of employment and give you tours, there is still opportunities for you all to meet employers and to gain an insight into what it is that they do and how you might be able to get there and how you can help yourselves along the way with the time that you've got at school and college and bits and pieces. So you'll be finding out the companies, you'll be finding out about jobs, but also we're going to be working on those skills. And each employer each week is going to be setting us a challenge. And what we'll be doing is, if you want to do the challenge and let us see it or to share it with us, then there are prizes up for grabs. So you guys will be up for a chance of winning an Amazon voucher for yourselves, but also your school will win £500 worth of IT equipment or resources as well. So it's really worth getting involved in those challenges, because there's benefits for you and your colleagues from your school as well. So Nicola, tell us all about the higher education encounters.
Yeah, so obviously, like, you can't get in to see employers at the minute, you also can't actually go onto university campus, and we can't kind of match you up with university students either at the moment. So what we're going to do is hopefully kind of make the best of the situation, and we're going to get some university students to come along to the Friday sessions. They're going to talk a little bit about their course they're doing. They'll talk a bit more generally, obviously, about life at university. So it's a really good chance to kind of figure out a little bit more about what university actually is, whether it is something you might want to do in the future, but also see how these students have got to where they are. So we're going to try and match up each week with the employer, with a student on the sort of relevant course. And we've certainly got a business student coming along, project management type student, as well as a creative student. I'm kind of working on the ones at the moment. But we also have students coming along who are studying chemistry, physics and astrophysics, medical physiology, English and American studies, and biological sciences as well. It's a really good array of students who are going to come and talk to you. Good chance for you to ask some questions about university in general, but also more specifically to our programme, to ask them a bit more about the skills they use, both now at university, but also kind of what they did to get to this point. So back when they were at school, what skills did they use? How have they improved and worked on those skills over the past kind of few years? And if they've got any tips for you guys as well in terms of what you can be doing to kind of improve on those skills too. So a really good chance to meet students, talk to them a bit more about university in general, especially this first week when you perhaps have questions about sort of the general side of university, but also about the skills and obviously what they might be going on to in their future careers as well. Finding out about their future selves too, what their plans are and how they're going to get there too. So hopefully, really useful time to be able to kind of find out a little bit more about university and obviously look at the skills in action as well.
So just around university, we have actually had a question from someone in the audience, one of our participants. So do you have to go to uni to be a social worker? Well, we'll be talking a bit more about different access routes into professions. You can go to university to be a social worker, but actually there's lots of different schemes now that are kind of alternative paths, so you'll still get that degree or higher education, but it could be that you go through an apprenticeship, or there's also other training schemes that you can have a look at. So you can go and have a look at step up to social work, and there's another one that I've forgotten the name of. What's the other one called? Frontline as well is another access to social work group. Molly also said that she might be going back to school, so might not be able to do all the sessions. Molly, that's absolutely fine. We'll be recording all of the sessions and you can submit your work and challenges and things to us at any time. So just catch up on them. And actually a lot of your teachers have said they'd like to be running these sessions in the classroom with you. So don't worry at all. And Alex, thank you for your points about punctuation. I do just want to highlight that actually when I type, I make so many spelling mistakes. So you're just still going to have to get used to that over the next 6 weeks. I'm so sorry. So thank you for those questions. We've introduced ourselves. I know what a lot of you have had for breakfast. So just keen to find out a little bit more about the people in the room and some of your thoughts and aspirations. So I'm just going to launch a poll to ask you a few questions. So it should all appear on your screen, and there's just three questions there that you've got a few minutes to answer. So tell us, are you thinking about going to university or doing an apprenticeship? Oh, quite a few of you thinking about university so far. And then we've got five skills that we'll be focusing on. Which ones do you think you've already got in the bag? And finally, have you come across labour market information before? LMI, it's something that we use quite a lot. We're going to try really, really hard not to use too many acronyms, but to shout and tell us if we're using acronyms or words that we haven't explained fully, just because you get into bad habits. Brilliant. Nearly had everybody's responses. It's perfectly fine. If you don't know what you want to do yet, that's exactly what sessions like this are for. And you're going to be in school till you're 18 anyway. So make the most of all of the careers, opportunities and insights that you get. Okay, brilliant. So I'm just going to end the polling there. I think we've got responses from pretty much everyone. 5 seconds just to finish up for those of you that haven't. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. End polling. So I'm just going to share the results with all of you, just so you can see kind of who's in the room. So we've got lots of people that are interested in going into university. So you'll get to speak to students and ask lots of questions over the next few weeks. Glad that a lot of you feel that teamwork is a skill that you're really good at, because that's definitely one of the ones that employers say that they're the most interested in. And we'll do a poll again towards the end of the 6 weeks, and let's see how you're feeling about some of your abilities and some of those five skill areas, because that's what the point of this programme is. We're going to give you opportunities to test some of these skills, highlight some of these skills, and actually I think you're all going to surprise yourselves by how many of these skills you guys have and you use every single day just in your day-to-day schooling or being and work and that type of thing. So without further ado, what are employability skills? So has anybody I was meant to ask people a question then, wasn't I, Nicola and Gerard? I was meant to ask everyone what you guys thought of employability skills. Sorry, we'll move on from that. But here on this slide, you've got some ideas of different employability skills. So I don't know if there's any there that you didn't even realise were employability skills. Personally, for me, I always think creativity is something that we tend to undervalue. And creativity doesn't just mean that you're good at art and things like that. It can mean kind of the way that you think, the way that you approach problems, and it's really about kind of taking that time to think about alternative ways of doing things. I don't know if there's any on the list that surprised you, Gerard and Nicola.
I think for me it was communication. So what we know when I talk to lots of businesses and we do surveys with businesses, the one thing that they always look for, and it comes out almost number one every time, is communication skills in their business. So I think that's a really important one to just continue to think about. It's so transferable, not just about how you talk to your friends, but actually how might you communicate a piece of information. So yeah, that's one from me.
I think for me, I think that the interesting one on there that I wouldn't necessarily always kind of put on top of my list is curiosity. I think I agree with you about creativity, Becca. If you asked me if I was creative, I'd say no. I do not like art. I do not like drawing or that physical creating. But actually, a big part of my job is creating new programs, new activities. And actually, I really enjoy that side of creating things. But curiosity, I think, is an equally intriguing one, I suppose, because I don't think you necessarily think that's a key employability skill. But actually, if you think about what it means you want to find out more. It means you're asking why. Well, why do we do it this way? You're not just kind of sat there going, yeah, okay, I'll just take that. You actually kind of trying to get a bit more out of it as well. And employers really value the fact that you are trying to figure out a little bit more. And you do want to kind of find out why to things and not just kind of accept the status quo all the time. So I think that's a really interesting one that I wouldn't necessarily think of as employability skill. But the more I think about it, the more I think, actually, yeah, it's a really good one. And well, actually, it really does add value to kind of any set of skills that you may have.
So all this time, I've just been thinking that I'm really nosy, but actually, it's curiosity. And it's a valuable skill to have. Brilliant. I'm going to tell that to my friends. I've learned something already.
So, Becca, Becca Imogen put in the chat that what if you struggle to communicate well with people, which I thought was a really interesting question. And you know, it's something that there is not one clear answer for, because sometimes it's written communication, sometimes it's verbal communication. But I think sometimes actually a really simple technique is just to ask somebody, do you understand what I mean? Because maybe you just need to reposition it, rephrase it, change some different language. So there are some simple things that you can look at, and maybe we can pick that up with some of our employers around when we look at communication skills as well. So good question.
Brilliant. So we're just going to go and look a bit more at what these employability skills are. So I've just got a video that I'm gonna share with you all. Showed you explaining what key skills are was made by an organisation called Success at School, and actually because of lockdown, because they know that a lot of you guys aren't able to get access to all the resources in your schools, they've got some really good career resources that they've made free, so you can go and access booklets. I know we've got someone in the room who's particularly interested in social work, so I've got loads of information and advice and lots of different career routes. And what we just invite you to do is, whilst you are going through and we're kind of watching videos and things like this, is we've sent you a worksheet, and on that worksheet, it gives you the opportunity to start thinking about the key skills that you've already got. I know a lot of you put in the poll that you think you've already got some key skills kind of in the bag, but just to keep a record of how, when you're using them and how they might be applicable to dream jobs in the world of work and things like that. So the next video that we're going to show you is called Shift Happens. And apart from having a really great soundtrack, this video just absolutely blows my mind. So we'll have a little chat about some of the things in this video once we've watched it. Here we go.
Right here, right now, 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 right here, right now
I'm going to hand over to Gerard. Just tell us a bit more about why is it we've picked these specific employers to come and speak to you guys over the next few weeks.
Okay, thanks, Becca. So, I mean, Becca mentioned we're going to talk about labour market information as well. So what I would say is that throughout any of the weeks that you stay with us for this programme, or just to help you as a point of reference for your future career thinking, download the World of Work Leicestershire booklet. It will have a lot of information in there, not just about these growth sectors, but pretty much every sector. Those ones that have been put into the chat, some things around social, healthcare, NHS role. So please do take a moment at the end of our session, if you've not got it, to download it already. We do a lot of work in the LEP to look at what the growth sectors are. And what we wanted to do for this programme was to actually just focus on some of those key growth sectors that we could share with you, where it's really relevant to what's happening in Leicester and Leicestershire around job creation, skills that are going to be needed. So we've picked out five sectors that we've got here. So we've got the creative industries, we've got logistics, cyber, engineering, and business and finance. So in terms of how we can use labour market information to actually help us understand some of those things, well, think about it this way. Labour market information can help you look at what jobs and skills employers are looking for, what industries are recruiting out there, where are they located? Are they actually in Leicestershire? We can look at the jobs that are existing, or actually potentially some of those future. We look at shift patterns, they're changing all the time. We can look at those sectors that are predicted to grow, but also, you know, things are changing in our world at the moment, and some of those may well contract and shrink. So we'll look at those options there. And then we can look at the kind of skills that are going to be needed by those industries now in the future. But also, equally important, pay and progression. So let's just have a little look at some of those in a little bit more detail, but not a great deal right now, because our employers are the experts in these and they're going to talk to us in a lot more detail and you can have that conversation with them. But if we look at creative industries, then above information that we've got on that slide, the trend tends to be at the moment for businesses to produce videos and for that video content to go on the website. So we know that's an area that's growing. But some of those skill shortages are in things like production management, broadcasting engineers, media specialists. So there's a lot of job competition right now. So going back to some of those personal skills, you've got to be tenacious, you've got to be good at networking. But opportunities are out there. And actually in creative sector, sometimes you'll find that there are opportunities that you can have as a freelancer, and they come with risks and rewards. So actually it might be risk because you've got to win the business, but it might be reward because there's greater flexibility for you. So, Becca, can we have a quick look at logistics and distribution? Thank you. So, here we go. The 24/7, 365, never sleeps, never blinks industry is logistics and distribution. Driving roles are in demand, but actually that's the first one that sometimes a lot of people think about. There's lots of demand here in other roles, things like sales, ICT, but also transport planning, software development. So don't just think about the logistics of when you order your package and it gets delivered to your front door. Think about the how. Leicestershire is a massive hub for logistics and distribution. We've got Magna Park, the biggest European distribution centre, growing. East Midlands Airport, growing. Segro Roxhill Development out near East Midlands, growing. And all those that grow, actually, they're looking for skills as well. So our location, our geography for Leicester and Leicestershire, around that M1 area, makes us ideal for this type of business. So we're a real hub for transport, logistics, rail and road haulage. So we'll learn about that more from Sam, who's going to talk to us. Kate, who's going to talk to us from Sandworth Brothers. So let's have a look at artificial intelligence briefly. Thanks, Becca. Wow, now here is a sector that grows and changes all of the time. As we can see from Shift Happens, just the application. So we've got some particular things that we're going to look at around cyber and security. And again, go and have a look at the World of Work document, page 22 on there, talks about a lot more information around cyber and security, some of the jobs that are out there around risk management, technology, innovation, all things that are growing, all things that business look for. And what we can see there in this sector is that the average pay is around £31,000. But actually, there are skills not needed just in Leicester and Leicestershire, but globally. So it is an increasingly competitive marketplace But tomorrow, we're going to have a look at that in a bit more detail, and we're going to hear firsthand from somebody who actually works in cybersecurity. So let's have a little look at engineering and advanced manufacturing, or even business and professional. Thanks, Becca. Just trying to catch me out there. All right. So business, finance and professional services. For Leicester and Leicestershire, again, a lot of vacancies here in terms of opportunities and careers. But employers are often looking for young people who have got the right communication skills, and they can build the technical skills up there. They're willing to recruit and train people on the jobs. But actually, we can go all the way up to those qualifications where you can get your degrees, your graduates, your masters, and specialise in business, finance and professional services. So there are school leavers offers and there are graduate offers there. But companies in this sector welcome young people who have got that motivation, got that enthusiasm. But as you can see there, I mentioned earlier, the top skill that's coming out that they're looking for, communication, every time on that one. Thanks, Becca. We could just jump on. So engineering and advanced manufacturing, that is a really big sector for Leicester and Leicestershire. 58,000 people employed in the manufacturing, 24,000 employed in advanced manufacturing and engineering. There are lots of routes into manufacturing, from apprenticeships through to graduates, but some of those roles in demand that we know about from the businesses include things like electrical and mechanical, aerospace, production managers, 3D printing and machine operatives. But the average pay around there is around about £31,000, so a really good starting point. But this is a key important industry that's growing for Leicester and Leicestershire. So I think that's all of the sectors that we're going to look at. Each one of those weeks, we'll do a bit more of a deep dive into them. And as we say, we've got employers who are coming along and they're going to talk to you in more detail, set those challenges and be here for your most challenging questions. Thanks, Becca.
Perfect. So we already said about doing the baseline survey. Please remember to do it if you haven't already. But also, we thought that we'd take some time just to find out a little bit more about ourselves. So you can see on the screen here, I've got three different completely free, relatively short assessment tests that you can do here. And we're just going to do the buzz test kind of all together, but I do encourage you all to have a look at some of the other ones as well between now and the next session. So if everyone wants to go on to icud.co.uk, I'll just put the link in the chat for you all. And when you've completed it, if you do want to just put in the chat kind of what animal you came up with as well. Gerard, Nicola, are you going to be doing it?
Yep.
I'm doing it now, yeah.
Brilliant.
I'm even willing to share.
So take the buzz quiz. So this one is going to come up and it's going to tell us whether or not we're one of 16 animals or one of 16 personality types. And the key to this as well is just not to overthink it. It's just a little bit of fun. These things are never 100% accurate and they don't mean you're going to go on a specific path or they're not going to predict your destiny. But just what we're trying to do here and just trying to think about where we're at now and what skills we need to develop or what career paths we might want to follow, this is a really good place to start. So, like I said, it's just one or the other. I'm more extrovert. Next question. How do you take in information?
Okay, I've got some interesting results.
What's your attitude to life? That's quite a big question, isn't it, for a Monday morning? I'm a clownfish. 6% of the UK population are clownfish. How about that? What about everyone else? What is everyone else coming up with?
So we've got Emma, who's a polar bear. All right, Emma, we're interested to know what it means to be a polar bear. Perhaps pop one thing in the chat there. Sophie's a koala bear.
Well, koala bears are cute. So, just like what I've come up with, you guys, you all have these kind of statements. So my motto is, hey, I've had another idea. And anyone who knows me will find that quite funny. And then it tells me my strengths. So it tells me that I'm enthusiastic. Oh, often a risk taker and prefer original thinking. And then actually this bit is particularly interesting down here. So where it says tips for clownfish. So prioritize, focus and complete the important stuff. So some of this you might be thinking, oh my goodness, what? That's exactly like me. Or what? I'm not like that at all. But again, it's just a little bit of fun. And I'm like Daniel Radcliffe, Jamie Oliver and Sarah Millican, the comedian. What about you, Jared? Which celebrities were you like?
So I've come out as a falcon, which I am happy about, because it does talk about going at 120 miles an hour. And it does feel like that some days. Famous falcons. Interesting. Barack Obama. I do like to think I've got some presidential qualities about me. Other people may disagree. I'm a little bit nerdy, so Doctor Who is really good for me. Sue Perkins, I'm not so sure. You might have to help me out on Sue Perkins. But the Barrack and the Doctor Who, I'm happy with that. I think what it means for me as well, so Imogen mentioned in the chat earlier about communication skills, and I think as well, these are really good things to help you unpack some of your communication skills as well. So yeah, I find these really useful. But like you say, not to get too hung up on them.
So Christian's like Daniel Craig, so nobody wants to mess. I'd agree with that. I'm like George Clooney and Adele. What about you, Nicola?
So I'm a black bear, which is down to a T, natural organiser, which is another way of saying bossy, basically. Realistic, likes to get things done. I'm a list maker. You know, I can't get on with life without a good old list. And that's very much me. And in terms of my celebs, Emma Watson, Alan Sugar and Victoria Beckham. Not sure how I've been compared to Victoria Beckham, but hey-ho, we'll go with it for the time being.
I can see Sophie's like Kim Kardashian and David Beckham, perhaps destined for multi-million pound celebrity lifestyle and a number of perfume and fashion ranges. I look forward to seeing those, Sophie. Right, so that's enough on the buzz test. So hopefully you've enjoyed this first session. And again, just a little bit of an introduction to us and to what we're going to be covering. And also just starting to think about ourselves, our skill set, and also some of the sectors that are out there and some of the realistic options that we have for our future jobs and careers. So this is what it's going to look like. So today was a bit of an anomaly Monday session just to say hello. But from now on, we're going to be meeting for the next 5 weeks on a Tuesday and a Friday. So the first session is tomorrow. So as usual, they'll be at 11 a.m. Tuesdays and Fridays. You'll get an email from me about 9 a.m. each morning that we're going to be meeting, giving you the links. And do remember, there were some people that I couldn't let in because I didn't have the name on my list. So do make sure that you're logging in with the names that you registered. So has anybody got any questions? Anyone got any questions about anything we've covered, how this is going to work and things like that? No, I can't see any questions coming up on the chat and no one's unmuted themselves. So that's fine if you can't make kind of all of the sessions, do join in as many as you can. And finally, we've sent you all the baseline survey, which I've mentioned a few times, to make sure you do that. But also, Emma has just put in the chat a link to an end of session survey. So it's really important that we make sure that these sessions are enjoyable and that they're relevant to you guys and that you're getting out of them and what we intended. So if you have got 5 minutes or so just to fill in the surveys at the end of each, then that would be fantastic. And there will be a prize at the end of the programme for our most committed surveyors. So there's a little incentive for you guys. So before we log off, we'll see you tomorrow. We'll be joined by our colleague Robin, who's from Hariba Myra, as we mentioned. So I can see a couple more questions. Nope. All right then, so we'll say goodbye. So bye everybody, thank you very much, and we will see you tomorrow at 11 a.m.